Hi, I'm John Zombro, and I hope you're having an incredible day. This video is the second in the viewer questions and answer series, and I'm already changing the name of the show to Ask Jay-Z. Welcome to episode number two. This question comes from Susan, all the way from Omaha, Nebraska. Susan writes, Jay-Z, I enjoyed your video on health and fitness, but you made a point that I would like you to clarify. You stated that exercise can be a stressor. I've always thought of exercise as stress reduction, and I've used it successfully in that manner for years. Would you explain how something that increases our health and fitness could be stressful? Thank you, and keep up the good work. Susan, thanks so much for following the Lifetime Body and for your thoughtful question. Let's dive right into my answer. Many of the things we experience in daily life have the potential to be stressful. This can include the weather, our social interactions, projects at work, and our physical output, including exercise. All of these things create a demand on our system, and that demand can go up or down depending on the level of challenge life imposes. It all adds up. Stress works on the Goldilocks principle. We need some, but not too much. A little stress is a good thing, as that gets us going in the morning, and it stimulates adaptation and improvement in our bodies, minds, and even relationships. But too much stress can create an overload in which we exceed our body's limit or tolerance. This puts a strain on the hypothalamic pituitary adrenal or HPA axis. To put it simply, excessive stress throws our hormones out of balance and leads to exhaustion and illness. When we have high stress, the term stress reduction is appropriate, but since I recognize that sweet spot for most things biologic, I like to use stress optimization or idealization. We are actually genetically wired to not just tolerate, but benefit from brief and intense or acute stressors. A startling moment or an intense workout usually doesn't take us down. It's the chronic levels of stress that modern life often holds that's the problem. Traffic, distractions, overstimulating situations, and many other offenders can push our stress out of the Goldilocks zone and into a bad place. In reality, the body doesn't actually care where the stress comes from. It just knows when it has had too much. I've been there, and I'm sure you have also. This is where Susan's question is most poignant. If we occasionally use exercise as a cathartic experience to blow the stress off, or more frequently as a gentle, restorative, and calming therapy, then it's all good. But unfortunately, what a lot of us, including myself, have done is turn our exercise into an assignment that can't be skipped, and we often do it too frequently and too intensely for our body's stress tolerance. That's the point I was trying to make. Exercise is great, but we don't want to turn it into the stressor that tips over our barrel of wellness. Always try to ask yourself, is your exercise something that you look forward to doing and makes you feel healthy and energized? Or is it something that you're dreading, leaves you exhausted, sore, and burnt out? The application of exercise is definitely an art form. And since it's a stressor that we actually can control, let's make it work for our health more than against it. Susan, thank you so much for that fantastic inquiry, and thank you for watching. If you're digging this information, give it a thumbs up, leave a comment, and subscribe to the channel. I'll have more great wellness content coming your way. Until next time, this is Coach Jay-Z, signing off from the Lifetime Body, where science meets common sense, and where you can make your body last a lifetime.